Hello everyone, Jankus here. Since I cannot really stream and I cannot really make Polish videos and English videos, I've decided to do a vlog in English. Przepraszam wszystkich fanów z Polski, ale vlog będzie tym razem po angielsku. So let me start off with everything one by one, I guess. First off, quarantine. I think when we arrived here, that went pretty well. We had like 2 weeks of prep where we were just basically locked in the rooms and, you know, just eating food, biking a little bit as we had bikes and screaming. I think that period of time was pretty stressful for everyone because when we had team practice, we couldn't really sit in the same room. And we were just, you know, after scrims, we were talking about the games, but we were trying to do it over Discord. And then it was like not that easy. Because sometimes it was like lagging slightly or we had like tech issues, but overall I think this period went well. I think that we had some decent scrims, and I think where the prep really started for Worlds was when we were out of the quarantine into the other hotel that we are currently in, stationed. I feel like we actually started winning way more games than we used to during quarantine. I feel like the first couple of days in quarantine were like a bit shaky for us, but then we started adapting to the meta, which I will go into details a little bit later. And I felt like, yeah, we started winning a lot of more games and the food became so much better. And of course we were able to order food, but also the hotel food was better here. And I'm like a very big food junkie, so I was super happy that we could actually eat like so much more good food. And I remember the first day here at breakfast, I ate like so much food and I didn't eat any sugar for like 2 weeks during the quarantine. So then I think I ate like so much sugar here as well. It was like absolutely crazy. I think for the breakfast I had like waffles and pancakes and eggs and boiled eggs and like fried eggs and like a lot of bread and meat as well, like sausages and yeah, like so many fruits and some like cheesecake as well, because it was like a cake day since, you know, we got out of quarantine. But yeah, besides that, I think we mostly focused still on practice after the quarantine period. We had one day out where we went slightly outside, where we explored Shanghai a little bit. We took some pictures that you can see on my Instagram. Well, if you are actually following me on Instagram, you did probably see a lot of stuff, but we took some pictures. We tried some Shanghainese cuisine, which is actually like the food here is really, really good. I'm pretty surprised because it feels like, it kind of reminds me of America where you can actually eat any kind of food in like a very, very good way. So like I've eaten like a decent Italian food. I've eaten like good Korean food. I've eaten like really, really good burgers. I have eaten like, of course, good Chinese food, yeah, probably good of like good ice cream and good sweets, you know, desserts. So I think I have eaten actually like a lot of food, but I'm also trying to like go do more cardio since we have time for it, right? I mean, I'm not really doing much, like I'm not really leaving the hotel except for like 2 days. So every other day I'm just doing like some cardio and like, you know, accept the practice. Okay, this is a cut for a second and then I need to check. So yeah, and now, like about a week ago, the group stage started, of course. I think our first game against Sanning went pretty well. Not for me, of course, but for the team. I think we have been, like we did do a lot of mistakes, and I think my jungle pathing was not optimal in that game, which made the game difficult in the early game, especially when I got caught around Raptors. But I think that the game went overall well. I think that Mickey and Caps carried the game very hard. We didn't really execute the team fights very well, and that's why we fell behind. Like even though the early game wasn't perfect, we were still fine in the mid game to fight for like all these drakes, since Ezreal was much stronger. But yeah, like I mentioned, we didn't really execute the team fights correctly. We didn't really like make sure Ezreal can hit, and then they would just catch him, and then, you know, the fights were kind of lost without him. But I think the game was a banger and it was very, very fun to watch. And I think that I'm very glad with the win because it felt like they should have won the game. But I mean, in such a game, like little details really do mean a lot. So, well, they lost in the end. That made us happy and you guys happy as well, hopefully. And then the game against Machi, I think, was much better. There was a lot of inting in that game. We had like a big lead early game, of course. You know, we had like really good level one strat where we killed Morde and then Camille was ahead, and then what happened is that the Graves cheesed ganked us bot lane right? Like, we didn't put a ward, so Graveslayer two ganked us, and then we were scared of a dive, so then I couldn't vertical jungle, and I had to go bot to protect my bot. And that way, I got also behind in the early game, but then Graves died after he killed me, which we traded, right? The kills, which I think was really good for Camille again. And then, well, I bounced back because my lanes were winning, so I could like farm a lot, and then I was ahead. And then the game, you know, we took a couple of good fights, good Camille flanks, good TPs, good Galio ults, which made us stronger in game again. And then, I mean, we had all the Drakes and we were winning all the fights, but we were also just running into them and dying because, you know, it's us and we like to do that. When we are winning, we like to have fun. So we didn't, again, we looked like a bit shaky, right? And it wasn't like a perfect game considering how ahead we were, but it happens. I mean, it's the fact that we also play on stage, which is not usual currently, right? We didn't play on stage since Spring Split. So I also think that's a factor that maybe made our games like shaky. But I do think playing on stage is so much more fun than online. So I'm really grateful to Riot that they made this happen and it's like possible. So I'm very happy with that, just like to add on the whole thing. And then our Team Liquid game, the worst one. So I think that was like probably the worst game. I mean, it was because we lost, and I think the draw was like not perfect because we did give them their comfortable champions, like the comfort picks, but we also had like decent champs from our side, right? And then, you know, the early game went to shit again, right? I died, and then they just started snowballing, and then we tried to like overchase set like once, and then we still made a lot of plays to like come back to the game, which was, for example, the swap when we couldn't like really lane bot because of the item disadvantage. And we had like insane Ash Arrow into Alistar combo in mid lane where we got two kills. So I think we did a lot of good plays, but the game was reliant on us being ahead in the draft, and we were not ahead. And that's why we lost that game, because I mean, it was very, very hard to play from behind with a poke comp where you basically have Nidalee as the only AP. So when they get some armor, you really don't kill Orianna, and when she gets items, it's like too hard, right? And you don't, I mean, basically you don't kill their frontline fast enough, and Orianna will kill you instead with Kalista, right? So if we are snowballing, it's different, because if we land like a spear and EQ from Jayce, it's like over. And I think we were landing a lot of poke in that game, like, but it just didn't matter because in every team fight was so hard to play, right? Because they were just not behind. They had like more items than they should have had. And then it's the whole subject of us or me being really bad with carry junglers. I think it's true to a point where I do think we play better as a team with tanks or like with team fight junglers. But I don't think that's only on me, but it is also on me, right? I think that I had to maybe go more into that style of like farming more, but my lanes also had to go more into like me helping them less and me being more comfortable with like just leaving them alone, which is not really my role for like so many years, right? Jungle was like about helping lanes. Now jungle is about like being very, very strong and being the carry. And I think that's fun, but I think that's something we're not comfortable with, and we just started exploring at the end of Summer Split in the playoffs. And I think that we are getting better at it. And of course, there's a lot of like positive messages or hate, I mean, both going on about this whole situation with me maybe underperforming. Of course, I want to do as best as I can. I'm trying to, you know, use all the time I have to play solo queue, to play scrims, to watch replays. It's not that simple, I think, but I also think that no game, I mean, you could call them unlucky. It's not really unlucky because it's mistakes, but that could be prevented. But I just feel like our early games are like very shaky, and I don't think I'm like the only reason why they are shaky, but of course I'm one of the reasons. So, well, I just want you to know that I will try my best, and the team is still trying their best to do well in group stage, and we will be playing against, well, all the three teams again, right, in the group stage. Currently, I'm recording it the day before the last day of groups, so we will be facing Team Liquid and Machi and Sanning. If we win all three games, we are first seed. If we lose them, then it sucks and we're out, so we don't want to lose them. And I think our preparation is good now, and I think I feel very comfortable playing Sala, Graves, Nidalee and Lilia, and besides that, everything else is in the meta, right? So I think I'm like feeling pretty good for tomorrow, and I hope you will feel good for tomorrow as well. I'm not sure when this vlog is going to be on my channel. Maybe today, so maybe you'll see it like on the day of the matchy games or like the group stage games. Maybe you will see it the day before that, I'm not sure. But all I'm saying is that, you know, keep cheering for us. I'm very grateful for all the fans for, you know, supporting us, and we are trying our best, and we will try our best because that's what we do, and we are too, and we are just trying to win. So it's not like we are trying to like leave these games because we want you to have a heart attack. We are actually trying to win, just in case you didn't know. And like a fun fact by the end is that today we went to buy suits because apparently suits in China are very cheap, and they were actually way cheap because you could buy like a measured suit and they would like do it for you, like make it, right? I don't know how is the word in English. Ushion. So that was really fun. I never bought a suit. Actually, I bought one, but never wore one. And I'm pretty excited to like see what I chose, which I chose very boring stuff, like kind of very dark blue and maybe like a black kind of. I think they named these colors differently, but I don't know how, because there was like 100 like types of stuff I could choose from, and I just wanted black and dark blue. But anyway, I think I will look good. It was really fun of for us to do this, so I'm pretty excited to like see the results, and I'm pretty sure I'll post it when I get it. So yeah, thank you all for watching. I hope you tuned in, and like I mentioned, please keep cheering for us. I'm trying my best, the team is trying their best, everyone's trying our best, and yeah, well, sorry if I disappointed you, but I will keep trying. That's just kind of how it looks like right now. Thank you and see you. Bye bye. Girls with the nails done.